Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine, staying safe at home, taking all the necessary precautions. Yes? Don't go out unnecessarily. All right? And take care of yourself and your family members. Now, since this is my first class of this session in class 5th, so, and there were a few students who are unable to attend the introductory class due to whatever reasons, technical issues or any other reason. And also there are a few more students who have joined us recently. So, for those of you who don't know me, I will introduce myself again. I'm Shubhangini Singh, class teacher of class 5th E. And I'll be taking English, Valedication and GK in 5th E. And computer in 5th E and 5th D sections. All right. So now, starting with today's class. Now, as you've already covered the topics, nouns and pronouns, isn't it, in the previous classes? So now you need to have that knowledge of nouns and pronouns to understand today's topic. That is adjectives. Now it is a very interesting topic. All right. Now, you've been studying adjectives since class 1st. You were studying it under the heading describing words. Alright, now what are adjectives? Adjectives are describing words. They describe something. They tell us about something. Now, what is that something? What do they tell us about? They tell us about the, or the adjectives describe nouns or pronouns. Now, what are nouns? Nouns are names of persons, places, animals and things. Four things. Alright, so the naming words or the names of persons, places, animals and things, we call them nouns. And what are pronouns? Pronouns are used instead of nouns or in place of nouns. Alright, so example, first, second, third person to be very basic. So, I, you, he, she, it. Alright, now what do adjectives also tell us about? In the junior class you studied, in first, second, especially, you studied it specifically that they also tell us about the shape, size, colors, number, taste, weather, sound, feelings, etc. Isn't it? Now, before we go further with the class, I would recommend you to increase the volume if you are watching it on phone and put it on tilt or rotation mode so that whatever is written on the board is clear to you. Alright? Okay. So, now all the shapes. Now, what are shapes? Say, for example, round. Alright? Square, rectangular, triangular. All these will be in shape category. Then size. Short, long, small, tall, short. Then, what else? Thickness can also be here. Thick, thin. All these words. Then, colors. All the names of the colors. Colors like pink, red, black, white, all these colors, name, whenever we are using them, they are also adjectives. Then number, say for example, 1, 2, 50, many, words like many, all these are adjectives of number. Then taste, when you eat something, how do you describe it? You will say that it is delicious, it is tasty, it is yummy, it is sweet, it is sour, bitter, salty, tangy, spicy, all these are adjectives. Then weather. How is the weather today? It is a bright day or it is a sunny day, it is a windy day, it is a foggy day. All these will come in weather. Whatever words you are describing for the weather are adjectives. Then sound. Now, as I'm speaking, I'm clear to you, I'm loud enough that you can hear me. Then, if I'm speaking low, I'm soft. Okay, then pleasant sound. All these are adjectives. Then feelings. Also, your feelings and emotions, all these are also, when you describe them. How are you feeling today? You will say, I'm feeling great, or I'm feeling awesome, I feel amazing, I feel excited, I feel happy. So, all these feelings and emotions, the words that you use will also be adjectives. Now, when do we use adjectives? we all know that they are describing words, they describe nouns and pronouns, but why do we use them? We use adjectives to be more specific and to give details or information about someone or something. Alright, now say for example, there are three boxes kept on a table. Alright, and I ask one of you to get me one box. I just say that, bring that box lying on the table. Okay, now you will ask, now you will go. Okay, wherever I've asked you to go, you will go. There are three boxes kept. Now you will be confused that which box I'm talking about. Isn't it? So, had I been said that bring the smallest box or bring the describing the color of the box, then you would have easily understood, okay, I'm talking about that box and I want that box. Isn't it? So, it is so necessary for us to explain or give details about something. And whatever we do it, with the words, they are known as adjectives. Alright, now say for example, she is a teacher or you are a student. You all are students. Now, you all are students. This is also a sentence, but if I want to express myself or if I want to give a quality of you, then say for example, I said you all are very brilliant students or you all are very intelligent students. So, I'm giving a quality about you all, that you are intelligent or you are obedient students. Alright, so all these words are adjectives, whatever we use to describe something. Now, say for example, let's take one example, Tom is a boy. Now, it is also a sentence, Tom is a boy. This sentence is over, but I have added intelligent here, that Tom is an intelligent boy. So, now, I am telling the quality of Tom. Now, what kind of a boy is Tom? Tom is intelligent boy. Alright, similarly, the cake is delicious. So, what kind of cake is it? It is, the cake is delicious. We all like to have cake, isn't it? Is there anyone who doesn't like to have cake? Alright, exceptions are always there. But usually cakes are delicious, isn't it? So, when you eat cake, what else can be used? We can use, the cake is tasty, the cake is delicious, the cake is sweet. Alright, so all these words. Then say for example, she is a beautiful girl. So now, what kind of a girl is she? We are describing the girl as beautiful. And what other words we can use? Beautiful, charming, attractive, pretty. All these words can be used. So whatever words, whichever words we use to describe something or give details, and being specific somewhere, those are adjectives. Alright, and to make other people understand better, we have to be specific at times, isn't it? Knowingly or unknowingly, we all use adjectives. Alright, so whatever you are using to describe something, the colors, size, shape, number, or the qualities of somebody, they all are adjectives. Alright, say for example, let's take this duster. Now, shape. What is the shape of a duster? We have to describe this object. It is a duster. Rectangular. Then size. It is small. And we can see the thickness as well. It is thick. Then colors. Blue, black, white. Alright. Number. Now, can you see two dusters here? No, only one. So, one. Then taste is not applicable. We cannot taste a duster. Then weather is also not applicable. Then sound. Now, say for example, in a classroom, I bang it on the table. It will make a loud sound, isn't it? And it will not be pleasant to the ears. So, we can call it loud. Then feelings is also not applicable here because it is a non-living thing. But if you bang it on your hand, you will get hurt. You have feelings, isn't it? So, this is how it works. Whatever words we are using to describe something are adjectives. This is clear. You've been studying this, isn't it? Now, and also I have told you that why do we use adjectives? To be more specific or to give details about something or someone. Alright? Then, you can just take a screenshot of it before we move on to the further class. All right. Now, in a sentence, there's a place of an adjective. You will ask that where do we place these adjectives or where do they come in a sentence? So, what is the position or where do the adjectives come? So, they can be placed before or after a noun. Alright, they can be placed before a noun or after a noun. Let's take this example. It is a beautiful flower. What kind of a flower is it? It is a beautiful flower. So, noun and adjective. Beautiful is the quality of a flower. Now, flowers are beautiful, isn't it? Nobody will say that flowers are ugly because flowers are beautiful, flowers are lovely, flowers are pretty. Alright, so it is a beautiful flower. What is the quality or what is the attribute of a flower? That it is beautiful. Now, why did I specify attribute? I will tell you. The flower is beautiful. Now, both the sentences mean same thing. That it is a beautiful flower and the flower is beautiful. So, flower, noun and adjective. Okay, so here noun is after, at the last, and here noun is placed before. So, here adjective is before a noun and here adjective is after a noun. Now, why is this? Both the sentences will mean same thing, but they have a word, a term for it. Say, for example, when we use it before and after. When we use it before, we call it attributive use. Okay? Attributive use. And when we use it after a noun, we call it predicative use. Okay? P-R-E-D-I-C-A. Predicative use. So, attributive use and predicative use. Alright? Now, here, when an adjective is placed before a noun, it is attributive use. When an adjective is placed after the noun, it is predicative use. Now, what is the difference? Here we are questioning what kind of a flower, what is the quality, what is the attribute. Attribute means, attributive comes from the word attribute, and attribute means quality. So, adjectives tell us the quality, and there is adjective of quality as well. We will be studying in the kinds. So, it is attributive use. Alright, understood, quality, attribute. So, attributive use. Whenever it is before, placed before a noun. This is easy. Now, predicative use. You studied subject and predicate in the sentence. Isn't it? So, predicate, predicative. What does a predicate tell you? It tells you about the subject. Subject and predicate. So, here, subject and predicate. Noun and adjective. So, here we have used it in predicatively. So, whenever it is coming afterwards, in the last, the adjective, it is predicative use. And there is another thing here. Can you see? This is a verb. It is a helping verb. So, in predicative use, before adjective, we have to use is. Say, for example, it would have been the flower beautiful. Can we say like that? No, the sentence will be wrong. We have to put a verb, a helping verb will come there. So, the flower is beautiful. Alright, so this is another key feature, how you can identify whether an adjective has been used predicatively or attributively. This is easy. Whenever it comes in the middle of a sentence or before a noun, it is attributive. And whenever it comes at the last with a verb here and a noun, then it is predicative use. Alright, I hope this is clear to you. So, I will just write so that it is clear. Alright, you can take a screenshot of it. Now, There are certain words, adjectives, which might have similar meanings but different words. And then there are opposites. For example, similar meaning words. Say for example, we take beautiful. Beautiful is a quality, it is an adjective. Then, what else can be used instead of beautiful or in place of beautiful, which would mean similar meaning, which would have similar meaning, just as beautiful. We can use many words like that. So for example, pretty, gorgeous, attractive, charming. Alright, so all these words can be used instead of beautiful as well. Alright, then what are more such words? So for example, unwell. Okay, you were asked why didn't you come to class yesterday, say for example. Then you will say, I was unwell or I was sick. Alright, so different spellings but different words and spellings but similar meaning. If not exact but similar meaning. Alright, then what else? Sick, ill, unwell, all these would mean same thing. Then another word like annoyed. Annoyed would mean irritated, frustrated, angry. Alright, so all these adjectives can be used for annoyed as well. Then courageous. Courageous and brave. Both mean same thing. So there are more such words like that. Then comes opposites. Now there are certain words which have opposites as well, isn't it? Now if there are positive qualities, there are negative qualities, attributes, isn't it? So say for example, the opposite adjectives will be the simplest, say for example, high, low, dry, then wet, and clean and dirty. What else? Brave, say for example, soldiers are brave and those who are not brave, what will you call them? They are cowards. What else? Say for example, if you are present in a class, if you are not, then you are absent. Alright, so present, absent, brave, coward, long, short, high, low, clean, dirty, all these adjectives would be opposites. Alright, then light, heavy. Now there are certain words which could be used either way. Say for example, we take sweet. Okay, now when you eat something, when you eat, say for example, chocolate or an ice cream. So when you had it, what will you say? That it was sweet. It is not sour. So sweet, sour, bitter, all these are opposites. Again, sometimes sweet is also used as a quality, as an attribute of a person. You must have heard somebody saying, oh, she's such a sweet person. So what does that mean? They taste it? No. It means that the person is so sweet. Say for example, sweet, that she's very calm, polite, kind, all right, cute, all these would mean sweet. Or add up to making her or him sweet. All right. Say for example, all these are. So you've understood there are adjectives which have similar meanings and we can use them. And there are opposites which we also use. Alright, then another important part of adjectives is comparisons. Why? Now since in this class we are only doing a brushing up or just revising the general topic, the clearing the concepts, so this will also add up. In the next classes we will be doing the kinds. So comparisons is another important part of adjectives. Why? Because we can only make comparisons with adjectives of quality. Alright, now there are 3 degrees of comparison. Quickly we will just revise it. Positive, comparative and superlative. Alright, actually there are only these two. This is the simple form of the adjective or just the word where there is no comparison. In positive degree. Say for example, strong. You are strong. Then then what happens in comparative? Comparative degree where there is comparison between two. You are strong but he is stronger. So two people. When we compare two people, we use first we use er form of the word, then we use than THAN, not THEN. Alright? We use THAN than in a sentence to make comparisons between two. And what else? With the bigger spellings or which have more than one syllable, we use more in comparative degree. In superlative, EST form of the word we use, and this is the highest form of the degree. Alright, highest form of comparison. So, say for example, strong, stronger, strongest. Tall, taller, tallest. Brave, braver, bravest. Now, say for example, more than one syllable. Say for example, beautiful. So, beautiful is the word. Then, when you're comparing two people or two things, say for example, a white flower and a pink flower. So, both are beautiful, but pink flower is more beautiful than the white flower. So, this is how we'll compare with bigger spellings or more than one syllable. Alright, say for example, beautiful, interesting, expensive, intelligent, all these words will come under that, comfortable. Okay, so more comfortable, more expensive, more most expensive, more beautiful, most beautiful. Alright, so understood the degrees of comparison. There are certain rules also which we will do later on. This was just a brief revision, or a short revision. Now, as we have cleared the concept of adjectives, I hope you've understood. So, let's do it with a fun activity. Alright, now this is, suppose, an object given to us and we have to describe it in more than five words, for example. Alright, so now books. The object is, or the thing is, book. Now, books are not just limited to your course books, isn't it? I hope you know that there are various genres of books as well. Books are of different types. So, for example, fictional, non-fictional, novels, short stories, or like the near course books, all these. There are different types of books, isn't it? Autobiographies, biographies. So, let's describe them. Okay, now first thing, how will you describe it? You will, when you see it, how does it look like? The colors or the thickness, it is thick. So, all these things you will describe. Then, what else? Qualities. Now, book. Say, for example, now as a student, can you study without books? No. It is an important part of your studying, your schooling or your graduation or anything for that matter. Isn't it? So, books are important. Books are important. Then, say for example, you're reading a very interesting book. Now, interesting again is an adjective. Interesting. Now, say for example, you're reading a very interesting book and you don't feel like putting it down. So, say for example, a storybook or a novel. So, they are also interesting or engaging. That you don't feel like putting them down. You're so engrossed in reading them. Then, there are fairy tales as well in the, when you must be small, then you must be reading storybooks, isn't it, the fairy tales. So, what is that? They are imaginative, they are fictional, then they are magical, all these words can be used. Say for example, magical. Now, there are comic books as well. What do? They entertain us, comic books, isn't it? Then, comic books are funny. So, funny. So, this is how we can describe them. What else? Meaningful. Now, books are meaningful. They, whatever is written in a book is meaningful, isn't it? So, now, say for example, there's a book written on somebody, on real personalities, their experiences, biographies, autobiographies, then those stories inspire us. So, books are inspiring as well. So, all these words, so let's do just these. I think these are enough because the list can go on and on. Alright, so I hope now the concept of adjectives is clear to you. All right, now we will be doing a certain questions. Now, in order to understand the topic better, these are four questions that you have to do. These are four sentences, practice questions. All right, so question number one, or say what the question is, underline the adjectives and circle the nouns. So I will just quickly read out the sentences for you. The first one is, he is an adorable baby. Second, it was an interesting movie. Third, the weather is pleasant. Fourth, my brother is very brave. Alright, so these are four sentences. You have to underline the adjectives and circle the nouns. Alright, and another important thing that you have to do is a fun activity. And I will ask you these questions. Alright, so what you have to do is, you have to write five qualities or five words describing yourself. Alright, once we resume the Zoom classes, I will ask you. Alright, so this is it with today's class. In the next class, you will be studying the kinds of adjectives. Thank you.